Thank you very much for coming along this morning to what I hope is going to be a very exciting anatomical experience. Anatomy for me is a very beautiful thing, even when you think of it as a body just sort of standing there and it's completely static. But when you start to move and you actually see how all of your bones and your muscles and your joints and your nerves and your blood vessels and your heart and everything comes together to create a fantastic kind of physical experience.
A big part of it is to say science is really exciting. There's a way into it for everybody, and a new way in is maybe to make connections with art and invite people in that way.
Loads going on. There's like acrobatic shows, they've got people from all sorts of departments at the university, they've got model brains, model spines, they've got robots, there's all sorts going on.
I'm a neuroscientist in medical sciences at the University of Bristol. I'm working in the Department of Physiology and Pharmacology, and we're working on different areas of learning and memory and trying to work out what sort of basic mechanisms are behind learning and memory in brains.
This is just two puzzle books, which we've put the pages together, so they're not glued at all. Like, you can look straight through it, but just interlock the pages. And if you try pulling the books apart, it's just pretty much completely impossible.
I'm Professor of Biomechanics at the University of Bristol. Like most academics, I do research about half the time, and I teach the rest of the time. When I'm teaching, I teach everything from cell biology to the musculoskeletal system. That's why I'm demonstrating that here. So it's the bones, the muscles, and particularly your joints. And I specialise in the spine. How we make the bones and joints healthy, and what goes wrong with bones and joints, often in later life, you know, what makes them diseased.
This is a project that I'm collaborating with a musician and an artist. It's called Dance Room Spectroscopy. And the idea is to use physics, mix classical and quantum mechanics, and then what we do is we basically let people walk through the force field. As people walk through a room, they warp the force field that the particles feel. And so the particles dynamically respond to their motion, and then when the particles collide with each other or with the walls, they generate notes. And then, so people can generate their own, crowds of people can generate their own dynamic soundscapes.
Right. Power of physics, eh?
Everything which you can't do in the classroom about science has an amazing impact. Being able to take them out and being able to talk to people who really know something. Whereas as primary school teachers, you're really a broad-based person. And we're doing science and space at the moment in science. And it's really hard. So we're off to at Bristol, or we're doing things that makes it come a bit alive. And you try and make it exciting, and this does that. So that's brilliant.
I work on robotics, in particular humanoid robotics. Though I don't look at the entire humanoid, I look at arms, I try and make them move in a more human-like way. So rather than having kind of your standard industrial robot building cars, very rigid, very dangerous, I try and make things that are more accessible to the human environment. So one of the goals of humanoid robots is to have it working alongside people or in the home or things like that. So it's basically trying to create controllers for motion that could do that.
I'm here today as part of a project called Changing Perspectives, which brings together aspects of art and science and hopefully makes people look at both art and science in slightly different ways. And I'm specifically involved with a performance that we're doing in this space, which is just amazing. This is Circa Media, it's an old church, as you can see here in the centre of Bristol. And we're talking about anatomy, but we're talking about anatomy in a very dynamic way. And we have an aerialist called Alice Ellerby who performs on a cloud swing, which is a bit like a trapeze, but it's a rope swing. And we're talking through all the aspects of her anatomy, her bones, her muscles, her joints, that she's using to actually do the performance.
The acrobatics and it just kind of blew me away. I was really surprised. And actually kind of having the momentum, just sort of seeing the physical momentum happen like there in front of you was really impressive.
The circus performance from the children's perspective, well, and me, but the children's perspective was amazing. Just hearing them say wow every time they saw something was great.
I'm kind of the physical accompaniment to Dr. Alice Roberts's lecture while she talks about the anatomy, and then I demonstrate different muscles that are in use every day, and then I do my cloud swing performance. And hopefully that kind of shows the audience the body in action.